You now know that you need to acquire certain knowledge to succeed in the financial markets. To generate additional income and make your assets grow sustainably, you know that successful investors have a common method for simply and quickly developing their strategy. You can no longer afford to desperately wait for profits to fall miraculously from the sky. You need a solid and effective action plan with ongoing support to enable you to make steady gains in the financial markets. Stop wasting your money and time unnecessarily, and finally give yourself the best chance of achieving your financial market goals. In this video, we're going to look at the concrete effects of the successful investor method on your success in the financial markets. To do this, let's look into the life of a profitable investor. Profitable investor generally goes through five phases in his life. I've experienced these five phases, and I now know that it's possible to avoid some of them. The first phase is beginner's luck. It's a pleasant phase, profits seem easy to you, and that's borne out by facts. You manage to generate significant gains in a markedly short time on just a few trades. You're not aware of the risks. You use a lot of leverage without even knowing what it is. You feel invincible, stronger than everyone else. You want to share your incredible performance and let people know how talented you are. This phase is usually noticeably short. Then, just when you least expect it, you suffer a significant loss that puts a heavy drain on your capital. It's the beginning of an infernal circle. You're now entering phase two, obstinacy. Instead of questioning yourself after suffering a heavy loss, you continue to speculate by instinct with no method. The more time you spend in the financial markets, the more your losses accumulate. To make up for your losses and maintain the hope of profits, you regularly deposit more funds into your account. You then act like a casino player, like a drug addict who needs his fix. Your risk-taking is maximum. Without knowing it, you risk almost all your capital on each transaction. Every once in a while, you may come out ahead on one transaction, but the problem is that your gains are small and your losses are large. This risk-taking generates strong emotions in you. Like all gamblers, you always look for the adrenaline rush that comes from risking your money and hoping for big gains. Those emotions that you don't feel in your day-to-day life make you dependent on the financial markets. This phase usually lasts several weeks. It's often the realization of the magnitude of the losses that puts an end to this frantic investment phase. This is then the beginning of phase three, discouragement. You lose confidence in your ability to make money in the financial markets. You blame yourself for foolishly wasting your money and your time. All that money that you worked so long and hard to earn, and that stupidly went up in smoke in just a few weeks. You stay away from the financial markets. It's hard to accept your failure. Once you've accepted the losses, you have that little voice in your head telling you that it's still possible. The hopes of profits return very quickly. After a few weeks, you again deposit more funds into your account. You hope that your luck will turn and you'll be able to make up for your losses quickly. The problem is that you always make the same mistakes and expect a different result each time. After losing your capital again, you end up wanting to change your strategy. You put yourself in the position of copying a successful strategy. You then look for platforms that let you copy the best traders. You pay trainers to give you their miracle strategy, their magic formulas, to gain effortlessly. Unfortunately, after just a few weeks or months, you realize that despite some one-off and sometimes large gains, which you are proud to publish, your assets do not increase durably. You continue to suffer losses. You have the impression that you have tested everything, strategies, indicators, and various types of tools, but in the end, nothing works. This is when phase four begins, awareness. You come to understanding that training is necessary to succeed in the financial markets on a long-term basis. This is the one and only way to achieve your goals. You are aware that success does not come without work. Anyone who makes a lot of money in the financial markets has understood that it takes a lot of knowledge. This knowledge allows you to avoid as many mistakes as possible, to understand how the markets work, to identify the right opportunities when buying or selling, and to make your assets grow with minimal risk. Gaining this knowledge is quick but requires regular work. 15 to 30 minutes a day is enough, or just at the weekends if you don't have much time. Your progress is constant and your results are visible. Your objective is to develop your own investment strategy. What you thought of as insurmountable at first seems simple and accessible to anyone. You then hold all the cards to becoming a profitable investor. You can generate regular income in the financial markets. You're a successful investor. This brings you to phase five, success in the financial markets. All you have to do is follow your own investment strategy to the letter. You go from payoff to payoff. Your losses are under control. This is the reward for all your training efforts. Gradually, a routine falls into place. You realise that being successful in the financial markets is really not that complicated. You're in a new comfort zone. You manage to generate additional income. With this new income, you live a more rewarding life. You enjoy yourself. You don't have to worry about your retirement anymore. You can share it with your loved ones. All you need to do is clearly define your earning goals based on your risk aversion. Depending on your goals, you'll be able to leave your job and achieve financial freedom. You have been successful in the financial markets. Your investments allow you to generate regular income. Now that you know all the stages in the life of a successful investor, you have two choices. Either you continue to rely on hope or a miracle strategy to succeed in the financial markets, or you train and give yourself the best chance to succeed in the financial markets. If you're in phase two today, obstinacy, you're a novice in the financial markets. You can skip phase three and avoid wasting your time and money unnecessarily by training now. If you're in phase three today, discouragement, you're an experienced investor but with poor results. It's time to become aware of the need to train yourself well to succeed in the financial markets and so transform these poor results into good results. Very often, the problem is not the strategy, but the trader or the way he applies his own strategy. Now is the time to act. Your success in the financial markets is up to you. Give yourself the means to achieve your goals. You no longer have any excuse not to train. Take the time to acquire the knowledge you need and put it into practice to succeed in the financial markets.